During the 1850s, in the newly founded British colony of Victoria, gold was discovered in the town of Ballarat. With this discovery, thousands of people, especially the Irish, came flocking to the gold fields. With these new immigrants came a flood of new ideas, political beliefs, mainly the ideas of Chartism, freedom, and democracy. The Lieutenant Governor of Victoria, Charles Latrobe, instated a mandatory miner's license in 1852, which costed 30 shillings a month. This license was very expensive and put a lot of financial strain on the miners. In order to enforce this policy, police regularly conducted license hunts, where they would harass the miners and dish out a £5 fine for anyone who didn't have one. These hunts were conducted in an overbearing, aggressive manner, and abuse from the police was rife. In October, there was an incident at the Eureka Hotel where a miner by the name of James Scobie was murdered. James Bentley, who was the owner of the hotel, was accused of the murder. However, the magistrate, who many considered to be corrupt, acquitted him. This led to a riot outside the hotel and the eventual burning down of the building. Soon after this, the Ballarat Reform League changed course. Up until recently, the league was led by John Humphrey, who took the peaceful approach of trying to advocate reform through negotiation. Now, the miners elected Peter Laylor, who wanted to pursue a more militant approach, turning the organisation into a military structure. On Friday the 1st of December, the miners rallied at Bakery Hill. They swore the Eureka Oath beneath the Southern Cross and pledged to stand true to each other and fight side by side to defend their liberties. A stockade was hastily assembled around the hill. On the Saturday, the men drank and played games as was usual for them, especially since the next day was the Sabbath and the men didn't think the British would attack on this day. Unfortunately for them, 3 a.m. on Sunday, the British army that had come up from Melbourne attacked the stockade. The drunken, sleeping miners were outgunned and outmanned. The battle lasted no longer than 15 minutes. Details on the specifics in regards to casualties are hard to come by, but it is believed that no less than 5 troopers and 22 miners were killed, with many more on both sides being injured. Despite the British winning the battle, they lost the war. Public support was heavily in favour of the miners, and soon all the leaders of the rebellion were tried by jury and released. The Victorian government was forced to enact reforms, including the abolition of the miners' licence, which was replaced with the miners' rights and export fees and the right to vote. The Eureka Stockade has left its mark on Australia, being considered by many as the birth of Australian democracy and a cornerstone in the creation of the Australian identity.